and Spirit bless. Alleluia. Jesus Christ is risen today. Alleluia. Our triumphant holy day. Alleluia. Who did once upon the cross, alleluia, suffer to redeem our loss, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
We gather on this Easter morning as the people of God. You are the church gathered in your home this morning. So, Prince of Peace, we have many, many churches. So blessed to have you all pray together today. And our first prayer on this Easter day, as every day, must be a prayer of gratitude. God has blessed us in so many ways. But also we're conscious of our own brokenness, our sinfulness. Indeed, we do not always have the heart of Jesus for one another, a heart of compassion, a heart of forgiveness. So we ask the Lord on this Easter morning to give us peace, peace in our heart, peace in our home, peace in our family, as we acknowledge our brokenness, our sinfulness together, as you pray with me. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your grace.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we may keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection. May, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to the Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they had not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, family and friends. And I know that some family of mine from Boston are tuned in this morning, and even family in Ireland are tuned in. So, happy Easter to all of you. Today is a great rejoicing and celebration throughout the whole Christian world. At the very center of our faith is the firm belief that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, in human flesh, died on the cross and rose again on the third day. Resurrection is a historical fact upon which our faith and our discipleship is based. When we turn to the scriptures this morning, there are images connected with Jesus that take us to the very heart of the meaning of Easter. Easter is an image of a woman on the way to the tomb, very worried about that gigantic stone that had blocked the entrance. And the image of Easter is actually what she found. The stone had already been rolled away. Easter is an image of Peter and his companion stooping to find linen cloth in the grave and see the body of Jesus there. But all they found was an empty tomb. Easter is an image of an angel announcing that there is no need to fear, that the Jesus they sought was no longer in the tomb. Easter is the image of the crucified Jesus raised by God. As the risen Lord, he gives us the promise of hope and life. When these are our images of Easter, no wonder we sang that beautiful psalm this morning. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We need images of Easter to carry in our hearts, for we are an Easter people, a people who have been redeemed by the passion and death of Jesus Christ, a people who have Jesus as their risen Lord. And so we're called to rejoice this morning, this Easter morning. And it's difficult for us to rejoice, perhaps. So much happening in our world, so much brokenness and evil and pain and suffering. But also, there's so much that we can be grateful this morning for. The doctors, the nurses, all caregivers of the sick, our people who serve in the grocery store, the drug store, our police who go around the city here every day protecting us, keeping us safe. So much gratitude in our hearts. So much joy in our hearts. Joy in our hearts. For today, we are entitled to allow our hearts to be full. The challenge to me this Easter morning is that all of us in our own church gathered at home, the domestic church, that we are the best version of ourselves. The very best version of ourselves. But the joy of Easter, people, cannot be content while the pain and needs of others remain. Joy leads to sharing, to generosity, to concern. So let us on this Easter day be aware of the needs of our extended family. Perhaps do FaceTime today. Spend some time with your children, quality time with your children today. Perhaps you know somebody who lives alone. Reach out to them this Easter day and be Christ to one another. Be Christ to one another. That's the spirit of Easter. And during Easter, we need to all see ourselves as peacemakers. Remember that first Easter, the disciples that evening, they were afraid and they went to the upper room and they locked themselves in their room. Very much like today, families are locked in their homes. The reason the disciples were locked in their homes, they were afraid that the people who killed Jesus would come after them and take their life away. We are not afraid of that today, but we're locked in because of the coronavirus has touched the lives of so many people, so many people. So we remember those who have died from the coronavirus. And we offer our prayers to their families this morning. They are in our thoughts. I said, on Easter night, the risen Lord gives his people the gift of peace. Peace that is not just the absence of conflict, but peace that actively seeks and honors love, reconciliation, and justice above all else. It is amazing that we're willing to sacrifice the gift of peace for our own misplaced sense of pride, righteousness, or perhaps for the short-lived satisfaction of yielding power over another person. Yes, we need to open our doors today and allow the Spirit of God to enter our homes, just as Jesus entered that locked door on Easter night. Jesus will come to our homes today if we open our hearts, and pray for that peace that we all search for. Perhaps we can pray, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there's darkness, light. That beautiful prayer of St. Francis. Or perhaps recalling the words of Thomas Merton. He wrote that Christ did not come to bring peace to the world as a kind of spiritual tranquilizer. He brought his disciples a vocation and a task to struggle in the world of violence, to establish his peace, not only in our own hearts, but also in society itself. So perhaps we need to ask ourselves this morning, how can I bring peace to my own family this day? We're probably confined to our home very much today because of the weather, and pray, Lord, that you protect all of us this day from the bad weather that is coming in. Makes life a bit more difficult for parents and children that we're just not used to that close proximity over an extended length of time. And I bet that your children are probably wondering, especially younger children, why can we not go out? Why can we not see our friends? Why can we not have our Easter egg hunt this afternoon, perhaps with extended family and friends? All very difficult questions that parents are going to be asked this day. And I noticed something recently that usually in difficult times, Sesame Street produces different programs. And apparently they have one at this time, and it's sesamestreet.org care. And it might be helpful to families that to help you to dialogue with your children about what we're going through as a nation and as a family and as a world at this time. I hope that all you children will join in this morning with our Romano family as they present their Sunday school class. It's on live TV this morning as well. And I thank you, the family, you've done a beautiful job in presenting the Easter story to our children, to the tiny disciples' church that gather here every Sunday morning. So, therefore, on this Easter day, what can we do? What can we do? What's the good news that the Lord is offering us this morning? It's the good news that God has a plan for each one of us. Each person listening to me this morning, God has a plan for you. And nothing can interfere with that plan. Not even the coronavirus, if you don't let it. No pain, no sorrow, no rejection, not sin, not even death itself. Easter holds out an invitation to each one of us gathered in your home this morning. You are the church gathered in your home. We have so many churches this morning. In fact, it's rather sad around here that nobody, I miss all the excitement of Easter morning, thousands of people coming to church. I miss your children dressed up in their finery, showing off their new dress, their new jacket, their new coat, their new tie. A great amount of excitement, and that's all missing here this morning. And I want to let you know that I miss you all greatly. But in spite of this, the good news of Easter, that the good Lord invites us to let Jesus help us trust again after we have lost our ability to trust. Give us that grace to trust. It invites us to let Jesus help us love again when we have lost our ability to love. It invites us to let Jesus help us hope again after we have lost our ability to hope. It invites us to let Jesus help us pick up the broken pieces of our lives and start all over again, even if we have given up. That, to me, is what Easter is all about, whether we celebrate it in a large church, large gathering, or whether we celebrate it in your home this morning, in your church, the domestic church, that's the most important church. Easter, the good news that Jesus has triumphed over sin and evil, and so will we. But if we do but open our hearts to his Easter power, open our hearts. It's the good news that Jesus is ready to work miracles in us if we open our hearts to his Easter power. We can perform miracles in our own home this Easter day. It's the good news that every Good Friday in our lives can be turned into an Easter Sunday if we open our hearts to the Easter power. It's the good news that we don't have to wait until we die to share in the risen life of Jesus. We can begin it right now as we gather in prayer this morning, all of us gathered in unity. It's the good news that nothing can defeat us anymore. Not pain, not sorrow, not rejection, not the coronavirus, not even death. This is the good news we're celebrating on this beautiful Easter morning. And again, happy Easter to all of you. And so now, as an expression of our unity, of what we Christians believe on this Easter morning, I want you to join with me in praying the Creed. I will use the Apostles' Creed, the more ancient creed. It's a summary of our faith as Christians. This is what I believe. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And so this day, we the people of God pray, as Jesus says to us, come to me, all you who labor, and find life burdensome, and I will refresh you. It is indeed in that spirit we pray today.
Our response is, Risen Lord, hear our prayer for the church, that on this most sacred day of the year, the light of the risen Christ, visible in Easter candle, will come into our hearts and remain with us forever. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people of the world during this Easter season, that we recognize God's gift in each life, especially those with the coronavirus, so that we can live together in peace and not despair. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are away from home this Easter, that God will protect them and keep them safe during this difficult time, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who will soon be received into full communion of the church, that their love for Christ and his church will be with them every day of their life, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that through the word of God and the Eucharist, we will be strong in faith, confident in hope, and abounding with love for the Lord and our neighbor, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters in Christ who are sick, those suffering from COVID-19, addiction, mental illness, and all those who have asked for our prayers, that the peace of the resurrected Christ will come into their hearts, bringing them health of mind and body, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those dying in poverty, loneliness, and pain, that we will help ease their suffering in death, God will reward them with new life in his heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whom the Lord has called and brought home to himself, that they will rejoice in everlasting life with our risen Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we now offer in the silence of our hearts, and for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, in troubled times, we lift our hearts to you. As the Easter dawn breaks, may we be united with one another and with the risen Christ. Lord, we lift our eyes to you, knowing you sustain us, keep us, and work within us always. And so we lift our voices to you. We celebrate today the day when Jesus rose from the dead, defeated darkness, and brought the light that inspires us to love one another. May we live to praise you. Amen. Then today, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at
your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his church.
You may recall on Ash Wednesday, I asked families to focus on gratitude this Lent and perhaps write a letter, place it in one of those jars of somehow and somewhere you've been felt blessed by the Lord. We're blessed by the Lord every day, but most times we don't recognize it. We're so focused on self. So those are the letters that you sent to church here and brought back to church. So united with all of you, we pray together today. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice and those letters by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet even more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim this day. Fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And so we, the people of God, we proclaim our faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember all our deceased and departed of our parish family. Remember also our parents, brothers and sisters, and children who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
So we are the people of God gathered in prayer. I'd like you to join me this morning in praying the Lord's Prayer. Remember, St. Paul says, there's one faith, one Lord, one baptism. So as a people, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and graciously grant them peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you all this day.
And with your spirit.
So you are the church gathered in your home. So please share a sign of peace. Ask God's blessing upon each other. Ask God to protect you and give you peace and give you the heart of Jesus this day.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God! Sing with me, how great. The lion and the lamb, the lion and the lamb. see how great, how great is our God. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to see how great thou art.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, thank you, family and friends, for praying with me this Easter morning. Hopefully the Spirit of God will touch your heart in a special way this Easter day. It's a day of family, close family together. Don't forget to reach out to your loved ones who may be living alone to call them this day. We're called to be the heart of Jesus to one another. We're grateful to our governor and for all officials in the state of Alabama for putting out some guidelines to protect us. I believe it's also the role of church leaders like myself to promote protection. We believe in the sacredness of life, in the sacredness of all life. So perhaps we need to be more conscious of each other and to the gift of life, that space, you know, keeping apart, that 6 feet, it's not easy. And then also wearing that mask if you come to pray in church or if you go to the grocery store or drugstore or any outing today is so important. So again, we try to do our best at this time, and again, keep in mind that we are a people that respects the sacredness and the dignity of the human person. And we try to be more conscious of this at this time of year, this with the coronavirus, than ever before. To help us to somehow connect as a universal church family this morning at Prince of Peace, I know that you should have received a letter from me during the week, an Easter letter. And in that letter, there's a card, the picture of the church in the front, then a prayer on the back. Perhaps I'd ask everybody today at 3 o'clock to stop whatever you're doing. If you're praying or playing or cleaning up the yard or having Easter lunch, please stop for a few moments. And as a church family, pray this prayer together. Loving Father, in troubled times, we lift our hearts to you. We lift our hearts to you this day and ask God to bless each of you. As we pray, may the Lord bless you and protect you. Amen. May his light shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's continue our journey this day in the peace and the love of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, sing.